Hey, what's going on? This is Wyatt Vaughn with the New Orleans Union Journalism Program. I'm here with
Chris Taylor,
Philip Betty,
and we're talking some Saints football. We're back on Facebook Live for week number three of our Facebook Live. This week, the Saints travel to Carolina to take on the division rival Panthers, who are 6-7 on the season, riding a 5-game losing streak. That's pretty big. Saints coming off a big win last week over the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, 28-14. It didn't look good to start, but they got the job done. What did you see in that game, Phil?
Man, it was. I saw a defense. Defense really stopped them. After the first possession, they only held. The first possession, they scored a touchdown, Buccaneers. After that possession, they only scored, allowed 7 points after that. Mm-hmm. So I saw a defense, and the defense really stepped up. And yeah. As the game went on, the offense stepped up in the mid third quarter, and they led the comeback, and they got the dub.
Yeah, what'd you say, Phil? Chris?
In the first half, the offense was really struggling. You know, Drew Brees, he only had one touchdown in the game, 200 yards. And he had one interception in the first half, and I think that really kind of got to him. And, he went back in the locker room and, motivated himself. And he came out in the second half firing, got him a touchdown, was able to finish off with 200 yards. I think the offense, it didn't show they were the best offense in the league, but they were okay. They were very mediocre this weekend. But the defense, they were the catalyst this week. They were very important. And the defense were the motivation. They motivated the team. We're able to carry them to that win, and I think the defense is going to be key, not only last week, but this week.
I think you guys are talking about offense and defense being the catalyst, but I think the key moment and the key play of the game came on special teams when Taysom Hill, the do-it-all guy, just blocked a punt. He does everything, and he made the key moment in this game. Saints were down 11 points, 14-3, had no momentum. He blocks a punt. Saints go down, score a touchdown on that drive. How big was that block punt?
Yeah, that was big. You know, that Swiss Army knife. Taysom Hill, he's been dominant the whole season on kickoff, on kick return, on special teams, even coming in sometimes as the second string quarterback with Drew Brees lining up on as a wide receiver, sometimes as the quarterback, running that read option. I think he's been very dominant and very important in a lot of the Saints' wins, in my opinion. You know, he's just been everywhere. He can do everything. He is Mr. Everything. And I think going into the playoffs, he's going to be a key man. And yeah, I think he's Swiss Army knife. Let's call him that.
Yeah, I think what's crazy about it is before the season started, he was on the chopping block. You know, he wasn't a guaranteed guy to make the roster, and now he plays everywhere on the field. You know, he's in on special teams, going blocking punts. You know, he plays quarterback, a little bit of wide receiver, maybe some tight end, maybe some running back. Who knows? We might see him line up at defensive end next week.
You never know.
Get
a couple sacks.
He
could do it. He could do it.
I agree. All right, so moving on to this week. The Saints play the Panthers this weekend, or on Monday night, actually, in Carolina. The Panthers have a 5-game losing streak after starting off 6-2. It looked like they were going to be some stiff competition for the Saints, but the wheels have really fallen off. What's going on with them, Phil?
Jeez, I don't know what has happened to the Carolina Panthers. They were looking so good to start off the season, and then ever since that, they've been on a 5-game losing streak. Even though Christian McCaffrey, he's been doing good, but yeah. Cam Newton, he hasn't been playing as his same. He's been throwing a lot of interceptions, been getting under pressure a lot, and his defense is giving up a lot of big plays. So
yeah, you say the big plays. The defense really hasn't played that bad for Carolina. They're just giving up a lot of big plays. If you look at the game, they just lost to the Browns last week. First play of the game, Jarvis Landry catches a 60-yard pass. He also had a 50-yard touchdown catch and a 50-yard run. So they really didn't play that bad. They just had a couple of big plays that really shifted the momentum in that game.
Yeah, the offense has been terrible this year. You know, Cam Newton, he did start off firing at the beginning of the season, but lately he's been throwing a lot of interceptions. You know, I think he doesn't have a real wide receiver he can actually throw to. You know, Christian McCaffrey is his leading receiver with about 600 yards, 700 yards. Mm-hmm. And following that, the next person has about 500 yards. So, I mean, when you're getting pressured on the defensive end and when you're getting sacked a lot, throwing a lot of interceptions, that doesn't contribute to wins. You can't win like that. You know, he had 4 interceptions a couple weeks ago. Yeah. And, I mean, when you're running back, it's your best receiver. That's not a good outcome at all.
Yeah, but I think even though they haven't been playing well offensively, you can never count out Christian McCaffrey. Christian mm-hmm. McCaffrey has had a breakout year this season. Yeah. Yeah. He might be able to get 1,000 rushing yards and 1,000 receiving yards, which hasn't been done since Marshall Faulk, which when you're in the same conversation as Marshall Faulk, you're doing something right. That's pretty good. So what do you see from the Saints defense that's going to be able to stop this Panthers offense?
Man, I see the Saints defense, they improved over the year. Over the last couple of games, I mean, the last five games, they averaged what? Giving up 14 points per game.
Yeah,
they've been doing good, very good against the defense and getting to the quarterback and getting a lot of sacks. And forcing turnovers also on the defensive end.
Yeah,
I think that's going to be a key this week. You know, he doesn't have anyone to throw it to, actually. So, I mean, if Marshawn Lattimore, Eli Apple, they can get a couple picks this week and throw Cam Newton off his game. And just and if our defensive line, our defensive ends, if we can pressure Cam Newton and get some pressure and get hands in his face, I think that would be a key to throwing a lot of interceptions, and that can lead us to a win.
Yeah, I think the biggest part for the Saints, I think it's the kind of come down to the front seven, because it doesn't really matter if you're going to be not really covering well. They don't have a lot of wide receiver options. If you can get pressure on Cam, force him into some tough throws, some tight windows, and then also if the linebackers can really make sure they cover up on Christian McCaffrey, don't let him have a couple of big plays. If you remember in the playoffs last year, he had a 50-yard touchdown catch that almost – you know, brought the Panthers back into the game and won that game. So if we can really stop him in the receiving game, that'll really help the Saints out. Mm-hmm. So moving on to our next topic, injuries. We got a couple of big injuries this week. Ryan Ramczyk, Andres Peat, Teron Armstead, all questionable for this game. Also, Kurt Coleman questionable for the Saints. How could that hurt the Saints' offensive line for another week?
I feel like we should be okay, you know. The Panthers, they don't have that many threats on the defensive line. And, you know, we get into the playoffs, and I feel like we clinched the playoff berth. Yeah. And we're looking good to have that number one seed. I feel like we should let them rest, you know what I mean? We have great backups. We have a lot of numbers. And I feel like we should be okay. It shouldn't affect us as much. And I feel like if we let them rest, get them ready for the playoffs, and we'll be straight. So I don't think that affected us as much.
Yeah, another thing with the offensive line, they might not be going up against a full-strength defensive line for the Panthers, as Kawan Short, probably their best defensive lineman, is questionable for the game. So if he's out for the game, that could really, really help the a banged-up offensive line. Also, Cam Newton is questionable for the game on Monday night. I'd imagine he's most likely going to play. I think they're probably just resting him from a little bit of practice. Yeah. You know, maybe he's a little banged up, get some rest. So he should be okay. Third thing we're going to be talking about, attitude for the Saints. The last 2 weeks, the Saints haven't looked like the same team since week, you know, I'll say week two because that's when they started their win streak. You know, they kind of came out really slow, especially against the Cowboys. They came out 13-0 against the Cowboys. That was their start. And last week down 14-3 against the Buccaneers. How big is it that we get off to a fast start in this game, Phil?
It's very big against Christian McCaffrey and the Panthers. We can't keep getting three and out drives and giving the ball back to Christian McCaffrey and let him run all over us and catching the ball against us. So we got to get off to a fast start and have our offense produce some numbers on the scoreboard.
Yeah, I think for the fast start also, the game is being played in Carolina, so I don't think you want to get that crowd into the game. It's kind of like the Superdome out there. It's a good home field. You know, if we can keep their fans out of it, that'll bode well for the Saints down the stretch.
Yeah, I think keeping McCaffrey off the field will be really important. Of course, keeping the fans out of the game will be important, but don't ever compare any other ring to the Superdome. There's no other arena like the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. No other arena. But, yeah, I think if we keep the fans out, I think we've been underestimating a lot of teams. You know, since we went on that streak, we've been a little cocky. You know, we went into the Cowboys, we went to Jerry's World, we underestimated the Dallas, and we seen how they ran over us throughout that game. And I feel like last week against the Buccaneers, we got our mojo back. We were able to show that the offense did something on the field. The defense continued to lead the team and carry the team to our wins. But I think this week against the Panthers, we just need the offense need to dominate. You know, the defense may carry us, but I think the offense just need to wake up and come out firing, because we're going into the playoffs, and we need our offense to score a lot of points. You know, just in case we may play the Cowboys again, we may go against that dominating Bears defense, and you know we might meet the Rams again in the conference championship if we win in that second round, which we most likely will. But I think the offense need to get back on their feet, and just Drew Brees need to show that he is the MVP, and Kamara Ingram need to continue dominating that two-headed monster. They need to wake up, and the offense just need to get back on their feet to help us win.
Yeah. So you mentioned seeding the playoffs. Mentioned playing the Cowboys. If the Saints get the one seed, the Cowboys would are most likely going to get the 4 seed with the Bears getting the 3 seed. That would be a probable matchup for the Saints, getting Dallas to come into the Dome. And that would be some good revenge for them to take them out in the playoffs. Talking about seeding, last week was a huge week for the Saints in seedings. Yeah. The Saints got the win, so they moved to 11-2. And the biggest game was the Rams lost to the Bears, got absolutely shut down. 15-6 was the final score, which means that with the same record now at 11-2 with the Saints and Rams, since the Saints beat the Rams, they have the tiebreaker, so they move into first place in the NFC. How big is it that they get that number one seed, Phil?
It's very big because we got to get the home field advantage. And say if we get to the conference finals, I mean conference championship, most likely we will, but you don't want to go to L.A. playing the Rams, and you want to stay in the Dome because we so far this season, I think we're we only lost one game in the home, at home. We only lost one game against the Buccaneers. We won. And it's very big.
Yeah. So I tend to disagree a little bit. I don't think getting the number one seed is that important for the Saints. I think the Saints are far and away the best team in the NFC and the league, but we'll stay in the NFC. I think the Saints can go to LA and beat the Rams. I think if LA has to come to the Saints, I don't think it's gonna happen. I don't think there's any way any team is winning in the Dome in the playoffs, but I do think the Saints would go to L.A. and win. I would still pick the Saints. So, I mean, you're talking about a situation of why risk your starters. You know, what if Drew Brees, Alvin Kamara, Mark Ingram, Marshawn Lattimore, somebody gets injured, you know, and maybe you don't even get the number one seed.
Mm-hmm. Well, I feel like it's not that important. You know, I wouldn't mind playing the Bears. I wouldn't mind playing. I really hope we could get the Cowboys again. You know, that game was bad. Our offense wasn't at the top level that we could play. And I think it's not as important, like you said. If we have to go to LA, I think we have a better chance of beating them in LA than LA does have beating us down here in New Orleans.
Yeah.
And you know, going back to that Rams versus Bears game, the Rams, that game looked very similar to our game against Dallas.
The Cowboys,
because the Rams' deep offense could not get anything going. Todd Gurley cannot run for anything against that dominating Bears defense. And Khalil Mack, I mean, he's up there with the defensive player of the year with Aaron Donald. He's competing for that for sure. You know, he's blocking offensive linemen with one hand and getting to the quarterback every time and forcing fumbles, not just getting sacks. He's forcing fumbles when he gets to the quarterback, and that's a key thing when you're playing defensive end. And I feel like we need to watch out for the Bears. You know, I really hope we could get the Cowboys, honestly, because the Bears' defense, they look like they could definitely get to Drew Brees. You know, him being short and everything, that could definitely harm him.
Yeah, so we'll do a little quick prediction. If we had to say, who do we think would get the number one seed? If we had to say right now. Start with you, Chris.
With no injuries, the Saints. Because the Rams, they got to play the Eagles this week. And the Eagles, they may have lost, but they look good. They look like they're not getting back to their Super Bowl. Wait, never mind. I just remember, Carson Wentz is injured. He may not play next week.
He's already out.
Yeah,
he's
not winning. And Nick Foles, I mean, we don't know what he's going to do. You know, he played good in the Super Bowl, and the game didn't up to it. But, yeah, I still go with the Saints, even though the Eagles may lose to the Rams once again.
What do you say, Chris?
I mean,
I think the Saints are gonna keep the number one seed because I think they know how important it is to keep the number one seed and get home field advantage throughout the playoffs.
Yeah, see, I disagree. I think the Rams are gonna get it. If you look at the Rams' schedule, they play the Eagles, who have struggled all year. You know, they haven't really played well. The 49ers and the Cardinals, who are teams who are both in contention to get top five picks, which means they're not very good. So I don't think there's any way the Rams lose any three of those games. So I think unless the Saints go undefeated, they're not going to get the number one seed. And the Saints have to play the Panthers twice, which not only are the Panthers a solid team, you know, they were 6-2 earlier in the year. They have potential. You know, they're a division rival. We beat them 3 times last year. We've got a target on our backs from them. And then we play the Steelers in between those two games, which is also a playoff team in the AFC. They got Big Ben, James Conner, Antonio Brown are looking good. That's going to be a tough game.
Well, I feel like, I mean, the Panthers, I feel like the Steelers on the threat. I mean, Ben Roethlisberger he's been playing okay, but, you know, his mindset is just, he doesn't, like, his attitude is he's going to throw that ball. He's going to try to hit Juju Smith-Schuster and Antonio Brown, and he doesn't care about throwing interceptions. He said it himself, like, against the Saints, you can't do that. You can't not care about throwing interceptions when we have the dominant defense that we have. And we will get to him, and we will make him fumble. We will make him throw a couple interceptions. So I feel like the Steelers aren't as much as a threat as you're making them seem. And the Panthers, I mean, we played them twice in a span of 3 weeks. Maybe the only thing that may happen if they may be able to adjust to our offense or our defense in that span. But I mean, I feel like we're too much of a dominant team to lose to the Panthers.
Yeah, so you guys both went Saints. I went Rams. Kind of like when I went Cowboys and you went Saints, and I was right. You guys were wrong. Just making sure you guys remember that. So another thing, Saints aren't playing at home this week. This is the last game of their three-game road stretch, Dallas, Tampa Bay, Carolina. How big is it that the Saints aren't playing at home this week?
I know you mentioned them playing in Carolina, and the fans will get into the game if we allow them to. But if we come out running, if we come out fast, and our offense is firing, I feel like it really won't matter. I feel like the dome, it would be nice to play. We play the Steelers in the dome. That's another plus in that game.
Yeah.
And if we come out firing, if our offense is good, we'll be straight. It wouldn't really matter.
Yeah, what do you think, Phil?
I agree with Chris. We got to come out firing our offense. We're 6-1 on the road. So and that only loss is coming from the Cowboys, and that's the game our offense didn't show up. So if our offense shows up this game and our defense continues to do what they do, I think it will be we'll get this win.
Yeah, see, you said kind of come out fast, and I don't know if you mean on offense, but
on offense.
I would say if they come out slower, not slow as in do badly, I think if they have more methodical drive, run the ball, maybe not big 30, 40-yard games and give the ball right back to Cam Newton and Christian McCaffrey. I think if you have a methodical drive, 5 yards here, 4 yards there, maybe a 10-yard there, I think that'll really take the pride out of the game, as opposed to a couple big plays, and then hit them with the big plays later on in the game.
In the last couple of weeks, during our streak, our time of possession has been really long. We've been able to keep offenses off the field, against the Falcons. We held the ball on, the first possession for the first 8 minutes.
Yeah.
And if we can do that, we kept Matt Ryan and Julio Jones off the field. If we can do that with Christian McCaffrey and Cam Newton, I feel like that would be a big key. I see what you're saying there. And, if Kamara and Ingram could get in the game and get going during the first possession, second possession, and get a couple, 10 yards, 5 yards here and there, that would really help them, keep them going throughout the game.
All right, so moving on from this week's game, let's talk about the MVP race. It's looking like a two-dog race right now with the Saints' Drew Brees and Kansas City Chiefs' Patrick Mahomes. Who do you got right now?
Do you even have the act? It's Brees, dude. I mean, he is looking – he's older, and he's looking better than Mahomes. I mean, Mahomes had – he had a bad game going in through the first half and the second half, and he just had a spectacular, amazing throw to Tyreek Hill somehow. I don't know how he got that pass off on 4th and 9, but he did. He threw it over his body, and somehow Tyreek Hill got open in the middle of the field and were able to get them down to the goal line. They were able to win that game against the Ravens. But in my opinion, Brees, I mean, he's throwing less interceptions. He has a better completion rate. And to me, that's more important than how many touchdowns you have and how many yards you have. But because, I mean, he's more efficient. He is the most valuable player on that Saints team. Without Brees, without our offense going, who would throw the ball to Michael Thomas?
See, I think
we can't live with Kamara and Ingram just running that ball. And we wouldn't be 11-2 without Brees passing the ball to Michael Thomas. Michael Thomas wouldn't have as many receptions, touchdowns, and yards as he has. No other receiver, no other quarterback can hit those undrafted receivers rookie receivers like Brees is doing. Nobody else in the league can do that. Mahomes cannot do that.
Okay, before I destroy your point, so
no other quarterback can do that.
I say Drew Brees is going to win MVP, but
always going against me.
It's gonna be a close race.
I think
Drew Brees is going to be MVP, but Kansas City. I think Patrick Mahomes, he's putting up insane numbers right now at the TD, like most TDs, passing TDs. They're going to rely on him more since Kareem Hunt is gone now. Yeah. So I think it's going to be close, but I think Drew Brees will still win.
Okay, so now the prophet's time to talk. Patrick Mahomes is more valuable to the Chiefs than Drew Brees is to the Saints. Okay, they now have no Kareem Hunt. They do not have a running back. I mean, they do, but it's not on the level of the Saints now. Tyreek Hill and Michael Thomas. Who are we saying is better?
Michael Thomas.
Exactly. So it's easier to throw Michael Thomas.
But Tyreek Hill is, super fast. Like, He's a speedster, and it's easy to hit him when you're fast like that, and you can get open in the defield. And Mahomes is throwing those bomb passes.
I agree.
He's not as efficient as Drew Brees because he's not throwing. Drew Brees can throw those short passes and still throw those long passes, and he's older than Mahomes. He's doing better.
Yeah, but Mahomes, this is his first year starting in the league. This is only his second year in the league.
He'll get one later, dude. Brees needs. Now, I'm not going to say that because I'm not going to be sympathetic and say, oh my God, this is Brees's. He might be ending his career in a couple of years. He needs the MVP. No. He's playing better. He's almost out of his career, and he's playing better than Mahomes.
But is he playing better than Mahomes? Because Patrick Mahomes has more yards by a lot.
But he's more
touchdowns by a lot.
But he's more efficient.
But Patrick Mahomes also throws more passes than Drew Brees. So he's going to have more interceptions. That's how it works. If you have more passes, you're probably going to have more interceptions.
Well, if he's better than Brees, he should.
I'm not saying he's better than Brees.
Well, then he should be MVP.
MVP no, wait, is the most valuable player.
But let's think about this. I know we talk NFL, but let's go to LeBron James. If LeBron James is the MVP is the most valuable player, mm-hmm. LeBron James is not only the MVP on the Cleveland Cavaliers, he was, mm-hmm. and he was the best player in the league, but he didn't get the MVP because James Harden was more efficient. He actually led his team to the playoffs, and he not only had better stats, well, not better stats, but he was more efficient, and he carried his team. Chris Paul was hurt, and he still did bring him to the finals.
Okay, well, if we're going to talk NBA real quick.
I'm just saying, if we're going to say the most valuable player, then you got to, like,
why the voters were wrong, because LeBron was more valuable and Harden was not as efficient as LeBron. LeBron shot 54% from the field. James Harden shot 48% from the field.
I'm just saying, his squad, for his team.
Okay, well, we'll get back to the NFL. Mahomes Breeze. I think Mahomes, because I think if you take Mahomes off the Chiefs and you take Breeze off the Saints, who has a better record?
The Chiefs.
Exactly. No, wait.
Exactly. Thank you. He said it. So, I mean.
No, the Chiefs. I don't think the Chiefs.
I mean, who's going to throw the ball like Breeze is? Nobody. Who? Taysom Hill, yeah, he can run that read option. And Teddy Bridgewater, yeah, he can throw it a little bit. But he's not doing what Breeze is doing. We wouldn't be able to rely on that run game.
I agree, but.
He wouldn't be able
to. The Saints have a defense that is doing great things. The Saints are allowing 14 points a game in the past 5 games. Are you going to tell me that an offense – wait, let me finish. Are you going to tell me that an offense with Alvin Kamara, Mark Ingram, Michael Thomas –
No, don't put Michael Thomas in there because who's going to throw him the ball?
But he's still on the offense.
Yeah, but he's not going to get as many receptions or touchdowns.
The Chiefs' defense is 32nd in the league in points per game.
Okay.
The Saints are in the top 10.
So let's get the MVP to the Saints defense. Let's get it to DeMario Davis, Cameron Jordan. Okay. If we're going to talk the most valuable player, like you're saying most valuable player, and then you're talking about stats. So, I mean, like, you got to – it's Breeze. Like, you know it. Just say it. It's in your heart. Just let it out.
Well, okay, we have a comment. Okay. If he ain't better than Breeze, why aren't you picking Breeze?
Exactly.
Because
– Exactly.
Listen, let me talk. That's a question for me. Because the award is not the best player in the league. If the award was the best player in the league, the award would go to Aaron Donald, who is the best player in the NFL.
Whoa, no.
Yes, Aaron Donald is the best player in the NFL.
Yes. Well, when we were talking about this is a deep debate. Okay, we were talking about Aaron Donald. You say he's not even in the question for MVP. You said
because he's not the most valuable player. MVP stands for most valuable player. If you take, in my eyes, most valuable player means if you take them off their team, mm-hmm. they are nowhere near where the team is.
If you take
now.
Aaron Donald off that defense, well, they have a good corners and things like that. They have
exactly. If they take
but
Aaron
saying,
Donald,
don't
they
say
are
he's
still
the best player. He's not
they
the best
still
player.
Have 10 wins if you take Aaron Donald off that team.
But he's not. They're not number one in the.
There's difference between best and most valuable.
But still, he's not
a big
the best.
Difference.
Well, anyway, let's not talk. He's not the best player in the league. I mean, he has the most sacks in the league, playing the hardest position to get sacked. Not punter. Don't say that again. I mean, he's playing. He got to go up the middle to get sacks. And Khalil Mack, you know, he's trailing him, but he's a defensive end, so it's kind of easier for him to get those sacks. But I mean, I don't think he's the best player in the league. No, not close. I don't think he's the best. No.
Yeah, so we got what two players with MVP options? Patrick Mahomes and Drew Brees. Those are the ones we're arguing over.
Yeah,
obviously, there's a couple more in there. Todd Gurley's probably third. Yeah. Maybe Khalil Mack and Aaron Donald if you want to go defensive.
Jared Goff,
maybe. You know, it's pretty much a two-horse race right now between Brees and Mahomes. I think we can all agree on that. But we can't agree on anything else because you guys know what we're talking about. Okay, so we'll move on from the MVP debate. We'll just agree to disagree, just like the Cowboys versus Saints.
Oh, and I have to say shout out to the Bears defense for beating the Rams. Thank y'all.
Yeah, y'all gave us the number one spot.
Yeah. Okay. How can the Saints win this week? Monday night, Panthers in Carolina. How do we get the dub, Phil?
Like I said earlier, got to come out firing our offense, and defense got to show up and put pressure on Cam and force him to – well, defense got to force turnovers and so we could get this win.
Yeah, I totally agree with Phil. You know, the offense definitely needs to show up. But I think the defense is going to be, again, a catalyst because, I mean, Cam Newton, if we put pressure on him, force interceptions, force turnovers in general, then we'll definitely walk out there with an easy W and hopefully a blowout so we can maybe get our mojo back.
Yeah, I mean, I was going to say something, but you guys pretty much said it. Force turnovers, come out fast, don't start slow like we have the past couple of weeks. And, yeah, that's a good recipe to win.
And who doesn't know what they're talking about?
What do you mean?
Exactly.
It's just because I went last. I would have said everything.
Brief movie.
Okay, so – the part that you all been waiting for, predictions. I am obviously 2-0.
Go first.
These guys are 1-1. No, it's okay.
Yeah, go for,
no,
go first.
as the leader, I say that you guys can go first. Phil, why don't you start us off?
I got the Saints winning this game.
Of course.
It's gonna be a good game, but I think the Saints are gonna pull away in the second half. The score is probably gonna be 35-17.
35-17. We got a question.
It's a statement. Do you take the bet? Read that before. Vegas
has Saints even for money.
I mean, that's a statement.
Winning NFC Championship game.
Yeah, it's a question, but that's a statement to you.
No, I agree. I think the Saints are going to go to the Super Bowl. I think the Saints will play the Patriots in the Super Bowl. So
But Patrick Mahomes is MVP, so shouldn't he be whoever that is that's gonna be?
Yeah, these guys don't know what they're talking about.
No, but you're saying he's gonna be at the Patriots, but shouldn't Patrick Mahomes be way better than Tom
Brady?
Well,
when your defense is 32nd in the league and you go up against arguably the greatest quarterback of all time, he's in Tom Brady. Tom Brady's probably going to slice and dice their defense, and when you now don't have a running back like Kareem Hunt, and the only bright spot on your team is your quarterback and your star wide receiver and your tight end. We'll put Travis Kelce in there. You're probably going to lose to a Tom Brady-led team.
Well, but if you're saying he's the best player on the team, it doesn't matter about Kareem Hunt if he's going. It doesn't matter because he's the MVP. And without him, there would be no Chiefs in a AFC Conference Championship. It doesn't matter, right? You're saying he's the best player and – you saying that. That was just saying.
I didn't say he's the best player.
But he's the MVP.
I do think he's the MVP.
Well, then they should win that. They should win. He's the MVP, right?
No. Okay, we're going to go back in the MVP debate.
Most valuable player is very different than the best player in the league. That was just stating. Now you're saying he's the MVP. Without him, they shouldn't even be in the AFC Championship.
Absolutely. If without him, they wouldn't even be in the playoffs.
So they should win.
No. As in, without him, they are a terrible team.
Uh-huh.
Nothing on their team, other than Kareem Hunt earlier in the season, Tyreek Hill, and Travis Kelce is good on their team. Their defense is awful,
mm-hmm.
which means if you took Patrick Mahomes off that team, they would be terrible.
Yes.
They are not terrible because they have Patrick Mahomes. They are actually tied for the best record in the league.
They are.
In the NFL with the Rams and the Saints at 11-2.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
So without Patrick Mahomes, they would be terrible. That makes him valuable.
So in that AFC Championship game, what do you think the score is going to be? Do you think it's going to be a high scoring game?
Oh, absolutely.
Because the Patriots' defense isn't that good.
It's better than the Chiefs. And the Chiefs already played Patriots this year, and the Patriots won 43-40. But that was in Foxborough.
Yeah,
and this game would probably be in Kansas City. Mahomes
wasn't as on fire as he is now.
They scored 40 points.
I'm just saying, Mahomes can put up 70 if he wants now.
Hold on. Y'all saying the Chiefs and the Patriots in the AFC. What about the Texans?
The Texans took a terrible loss last week.
Okay.
And they didn't look that good taking that loss.
But let's think about this. The Texans have not played one team and will not play one team with a winning record.
Yeah.
this entire season, when they've played a team, they've had a losing record or an even record. In the last three games.
Yeah. Well, the Texans, they're out of contention now. I mean, I feel like the Steelers are a better team than them.
Yeah, I would agree.
Yeah. I mean, oh, and
the Chargers.
There you go. That's what I'm about to say. The Chargers play the Chiefs tonight. We're going to see if Patrick Mahomes is the MVP tonight. We're going to see for sure. Because the Chargers defense, I mean, they're not the best.
But they're good.
Yeah, but they're good. We're going to see tonight.
Okay. Yeah. Well, let's just remember, the Chiefs have the 32nd best defense. They wouldn't be in the playoffs without Patrick Mahomes. So we'll go back to the predictions for the actual game. I think you said 35-17.
That's a good point. Okay. That's a good point. Wait, hold up. I think Breeze should get it because he does it constantly year after year. But Mahomes, yes, this is his sophomore year, and this is his first year starting. So, I mean.
Okay, but it's not a participation trophy. You can't give it to someone because they deserve it year after year, and they don't deserve it 1 year. That's like LeBron James. LeBron James should probably win the NBA MVP every single year.
Since he got into the league, you shouldn't
give it to him because he deserves it year after year. You should give it to him because he deserves it that year. And in my opinion, I don't think Drew Brees deserves it this year. We still have three games to play. I think it's Mahomes and him. And I think Drew Brees has a chance to rectify his case. Patrick Mahomes might have some bad games.
We'll see. Have a bad game tonight.
He might. I don't think so. But we'll see. All right. So look, we need to wrap this up. Prediction for the Saints-Panthers. No more MVP. Patrick Mahomes is going to win.
Well, I feel like the Saints, they will win. Well, against the Panthers, Breeze, of course, will rectify his campaign for the MVP by throwing 500 yards, 4 touchdowns.
Which he will win.
Yes, thank you very much, Phil. And the Saints will win with a score of about 48. I mean, I feel like the Saints will come off
48.
I'm going to give them 36. 36. 36 to, like, depending on the defense, I'm going to say 10.
36-10.
10-14. 10-14. Really? Something like that.
Okay. 36. I'm going 36-14. See, look, this is why I'm winning the predictions. You guys are making it too easy. All I had to do was pick against the Saints one time, and now all you guys do is pick the Saints. As long as I keep picking the Saints, I'm never going to come out of first place. So I'm picking the Saints so that I can stay in first place. No, but on a serious note, I do think the Saints will win. I think it'll be closer than you guys are saying. I'm going to go with 30-17. Saints win 30-17. It's closer than you guys said. I think it'll be close to start out, kind of like the Tampa game. I don't think we'll go down 11, but I think it'll be close to start out. I think in the second half, the Panthers are going to struggle. Think about this. The Saints defense hasn't given up a point in the last two second halves they've played. That's pretty crazy. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's pretty crazy.
It's crazy when you think about it because people say we got ran over by the Cowboys. They didn't even score in the second half. We just couldn't do anything on offense.
Like, exactly.
I mean, if the offense come out firing, like I said, we'll dominate them like we did when we was on that 10-game win streak. That's all we need, the offense.
All right.
We'll blow out teams for sure.
That's all we've got for you today. In recap, Patrick Mahomes winning the
MVP. I want y'all to tune into this game tonight. We'll see. We'll see if he's really the MVP.
All right. Well, this is all we've got for you today. I'm Wyatt Vaughn with JRNOLA. This is Phil Petty. This is Chris Taylor. Thank you for watching. We'll be back next week with a preview of the Saints versus the Steelers.
Monday night, baby.
Goodbye.